General. Why I?
Hey you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so glad that you guys decided to return. If this is your first time on my channel, then what's goody, girl? What's happening? I'm glad you decided to pop one and I'm glad you found my channel. Go ahead and click that like button, subscribe if you're not already, and make sure that your post notification bells is on because you don't want to miss videos by your girl, okay? So today I'm putting you guys on. I know a lot of you guys are in the house in quarantine and can't get your hair done. You can't go to the salon, none of that. Your girl feels for you. So I'm trying to put y'all on to how to do these stitch braids, these Pop Smoke braids. Shout out to the Woo. Rest in peace. We lost a good one. But these braids are very trendy and I'm going to show you guys how I attempted to do it, okay? So I'm starting off by parting the hair, and when I part the hair, I like to put the jam. I showed you guys the jam that I'm using. I like to use this one because it doesn't turn white on the hair and it has a good hold and all that good. Going to be braiding. I'm going to be applying some of the jam on both sides of that section. Also, it's going to help to keep the braid section as neat as possible so that you get a cleaner look when you're braiding. So when I'm starting to stitch braid, I'm taking that first section and I'm braiding it as if it's just a 3-strand braid. And I'm doing that maybe 3 times. I'm going into the braiding. Then I'm going to move on to the next section. So I'm adding hair, and I'm gonna leave the right strand alone. I'm not gonna use that yet, but I'm gonna braid with the left strand. As you can see, I'm adding in the left strand and I'm braiding. Then I'm adding the right strand onto the top portion that has no hair included. And then I'm going to create my second stitch and make sure it's nice and neat. And then I'm gonna braid the entire thing to the other side, where I'm going to also part that same second stitch on the left-hand side. I'm gonna braid through, and then I'm gonna continue the same pattern, create a I'm done with all the braids. I'm gonna go ahead and fleek up these edges right quick, because your girl can't just have some braids without no edges being fleeked, okay? So I'm using a toothbrush and I'm using the same jam to slick them down, and then I'm going to do the same thing to the other side, and I'm going to secure the end of that little swoop with the comb, because sometimes, you know, it just doesn't look seamless. I don't know, I just like to tuck it. But after that, I'm gonna wrap it down just so that it kind of gets a little lay, and then I'm gonna get to cleaning the braids. I actually took a scissor to trim the ends, and also just some flyaways all throughout the braids, but I didn't show that part. Once I was done with that, I went in with some hot water and just dipped the braids to seal the braids, and just to loosen them up, because sometimes your braid could be a little stiff, and the hot water just loosens them up and also just calms the flyaways that might be there. Grab some mousse, and this is the same mousse that I use to do my lace fronts when I'm doing baby hairs, and it does not lift the lace. It's my favorite type of mousse. So that's what I use, and I'm just putting it on the ends of the braids. I'm not putting it on any part of her hair that is her natural real hair, because it's gonna revert. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope that the steps were easy to pick up on. I'm not the best at stitch braids, but over time they will get better and better. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you guys in the next video.